Hey, Mr. Martin, Frost Driving School. Do you like distractions? Probably most people don't. When I'm focused on something, or maybe you're really trying to get something done in the classroom, and something happens, like someone throws something, or makes a noise, or does that. That's distracting, right? So today, we gotta talk about distractions in the cars. Noises outside, noises inside, visual distractions, biomechanical distractions. What's that? That's when these little digits are not on the steering wheel and we're doing something else. But don't do this, okay? Putting makeup on, all this different stuff, eating something, things that you might see other people do, that's a biomechanical distraction. And the other one is this. You think too much and you're not focused on the driving anymore. That's called cognition. It's good to be thinking about the driving task at hand. So let's take a look at these four things real quickly and give you a couple examples of what distracted driving is. Okay, so driver inattention and distracted driving. Driving is a complex task. Safe driving requires drivers to stay focused on the driving task. When a driver's awareness and focus drift to anything other than the driving task, then that is called driver inattention. So drivers who are inattentive may look but not see conflicts ahead or around other vehicles. Have you ever ridden in the back of someone's vehicle or in the front and all of a sudden you got home and you're like, how in the world did we get here? And you were just distracted. You were focused on something else, okay? However, driver inattention may be unintentional fatigue, right? Unintentional physical conditions. Fatigue, though, often causes drivers' attention to drift away from the driving task. When there's an event, person, or activity or object that's drawing your driver attention away from the driving task, then that is what we call distracted driving. A key difference between driver distraction and driver inattention in general is that the driver distraction is caused by an event that directs the focus of a driver away from the driving task. If a drink falls out of the holder and spills on the floor while the driver is making a turn, then the driver is likely to become distracted as he or she quickly focuses on the fallen cup rather than the turn. So let's take a look at these four classifications, all right? Cognitive distractions. A cognitive distraction is when your mind is lost in thought or a daydream. Obviously, talking on a cell phone, it's against the law in the state of Texas. If you didn't know this, 2017, anyone, regardless of age, that holds a phone up to their ear while driving, that's a cognitive distraction. $499 plus an additional $250 if it's done in a school zone. Don't throw your money away. All right, now, visual distractions is anything that causes you to take your eyes off the roadway. For instance, bright lights. For instance, people out by the side of the road like having a conversation, you stare at them. I've been having young drivers once time actually saw a squirrel and they said squirrel and stared at it. That is a visual distraction. And then it turned into cognitive distraction because they were thinking about it and I had to get them refocused. Auditory distractions. The greatest example of this is going to come from our film, Wayne's World. Check this out. This is funny. Okay, anything that causes you to have loud sounds and auto distractions, obviously that's not the thing that we want to do, okay? Auditory distractions, keep your music down, be in control at all times. And finally, biomechanical distractions, as with our example, any mechanical act that's not specifically related to the driving task that's performed by the driver is a biomechanical distraction. So, pushing a button on the phone, pushing a dial on the radio, anything, picking up a soft drink. If you don't have two hands on the wheel, then that's considered a biomechanical distraction. There are things you can do when driving to avoid being distracted, okay? So understand what they are. Let's listen again here at the end of the video on how to do that. All right, real basically, let me just take this right out of our textbook about how to manage distractions. May I? It says here, there are things you can do when driving to avoid being distracted. If you are fatigued, stop. Hello. And also, just get out. Switch drivers if you have to. Limit your conversation with passengers and always, always avoid emotional conversations. Look, when you're learning how to drive for the first time, you don't need someone chewing into your right ear over here saying something, and you don't want to be looking at them having a heated discussion because you're trying to learn how to drive. That's a distraction. So if you're the trainer, take your time, take a breath, have a plan. Don't distract your young driver or adult driver learning how to drive. The other one too is read the owner's manual. Oh my gosh, like we have a video on how to use turn signals and how to shift gears and where's the gas and where's the brake and where's all the controls in there and the windshield wipers. We've got some really good rain going on right now in Texas, and so you want to know where all those controls are at. What happens when you have a blue light on your dashboard? Those types of distractions. Someone tells you to turn the lights off. You got to know how to do all those different things when you're driving down the road. So be safe at all times. And finally, take control of the environment inside your vehicle by setting the rules for passengers that are with you. Remember, if you're under the age of 18, you can only have one passenger in the vehicle with you in the front seat, and you have to have that during your probationary period. But you can have as many family members as you want if you're under the age of 18. So there's some rules with your driver's license that you need to understand because of distractions. All right, so see you on the road. Be safe, be focused, and always, always take your time whenever you're going somewhere. Have a great day.